discussion, if that works. So I mentioned it to my professor that looks after me at King's College England. He said, look, Gary, probably you may need some tablets or a change of your diet, but just you better come in and do some tests. So I went in the following day, did some tests, gave me an angiogram. And I know the heart specialist was doing it, and as he was doing it, I could see his face, and he looked at me and said, Gary, we've got a problem. He said, your main artery to your heart, 3 centimetres area, is nearly blocked. He said, we've got to get you in as soon as we can. So that was on the Friday. I went in on the Monday, had a 7-hour operation, and I was in critical care for 2 nights, but then back to the ward for a week, and then back home. So that was 3 months ago now. So obviously all the work's been done, hopefully. I've been diabetic for 40 years now. So, that's one of the complications is your circulation. And 2 years ago, I nearly lost my leg through another problem with circulation. So I've got a scar that goes from my groin down to my foot, where it's getting the blood back to the leg. So all those are complications that can happen. But as far as myself,
you can't keep a good man down.
Is that every single one of us, you know, we all get curveballs to deal with throughout our lives. And I've always, from a young age, it's how you deal with those curveballs makes the person that you are. So yes, sometimes you're going to feel, why me? Why, you know, I can't believe it's me. I mean, like when they told me about my heart, they said, Gary, you have to have a heart bypass. I said, excuse me, I said, surely that's for, I always thought that was for old gits who are about to die, not teenagers like me. You know, because you still think of yourself as being young, no matter what age you are. So, but no, I went in, I've got a fantastic team of surgeons to look after me. I'm under King's College in Peckham in London. My 3 professors for my diabetes, for my heart, and for my vascular surgeons, they're all based at that hospital. They all got together on that Friday to make the best decisions for me. So I say I'm very lucky. I've got a very good team to look after me. So health-wise, I'm absolutely great.
Right.
And even better, I have to just say, Tottenham Hotspur Football Club is in the best position it has been for a long time.
So you'll be playing again, Gary.
And off the field of play. Our training ground is absolutely stunning. The new stadium is going to be amazing. I mean, I've seen all the pictures, all the things that are happening to him, what's going to happen inside the stadium. You know, this slide-in, slide-out pitch. So they can have probably a football match, you know, during the day. The following day, they can have NFL, they can have concerts. So obviously, hopefully, all the money that's raised for those other events will go into the football side, and hopefully we'll keep the... all those things are going to happen. Yes, we can't wait to move into the stadium. Of course, we've got a year at Wembley, but, you know, that's, to me... People keep asking me about Wembley. Personally, utter nonsense that people are saying that... The only difference with Wembley is the fact is that when teams came to us at Wild Heart Lane last year, we only conceded 4 points at the stadium last year. So they're coming into our fortress. It's a cauldron of Wild Heart Lane. Now they're going to Wembley.
So is there a FA Cup final?
The teams are going to play there. They don't have that fortress of White Hart Lane on top of them. So that's the only thing. As far as our performances, they should be as good, if not better, than they were last year. Because we've got a fantastic squad of players. They've been together for another year since last season. Not only that, the players that we've brought in, this year, everyone says we aren't making massive signings, whatever. It's not going to happen. We're not going to make massive signings whilst the stadium's being built and all the cost of all that. That's pure economic fact. But the players we have brought in are exactly what we've needed to add depth to our squad. You know, obviously, Aurier is disappointed with the sending off, unnecessary. He does go to the ground quite a lot, but you know, he's got a bit of Carl Walker in him. As far as you know, I've seen him play over the years. Sanchez, I like him at the back. I think he's another player that I see a bit of Ledley King in him. All these things, putting all that together, we've got a squad. And the most important thing is that we've got a squad of players that we are keeping together. The last time we had a squad like this, or we started to build a squad like this, we had Luka Modric, Van der Vaart, Bale, and they all went. Yes. But at the moment, we've got players that want to play for Tottenham. And yes, through this summer, there were a number of clubs looking at our players. But our players wanted to stay. So obviously Kyle Walker has moved on. Yeah, obviously I don't know the real reasons of why he went, whatever, but the manager believes we've got some, you know, obviously Trippier, other players coming through. I like Kyle. Yeah, last season, certainly in the first half of the season, I thought Kyle Walker and Danny Rose were our best two attacking players.
Oh, yeah, best defence.
Yeah, you know, getting the balls in the box there, the goals were scoring. But again, we only lost one player, and we replaced that player with a player of, you know, of top quality as well. So, for me, it's the most fantastic time to be a Spurs fan. I'm a Spurs fan now. Yeah. And obviously, I was great. I had one full 16 years as a player and 11 years as captain there. But now I'm a Spurs fan. And I think for us Spurs fans now, this is a great time to be
a absolutely.
TDW.
Come on, you Spurs.
Tottenham till we die.
Absolutely, absolutely. So, what I thought I would do, rather than just could talk about things in the career and blah, 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 I thought I'd let you ask me what you want to know. So, you can ask me about my football career, my private life. I don't mind.
Can I ask you a question?
I may dodge a few questions if I have to.
How much did it cost Tottenham to buy you for Bristol Rovers?
How much did it cost Tottenham to buy me for Bristol Rovers? Well, I have to tell you, I was the season before Tottenham bought me, Ipswich Town were going to buy me. Yeah. And Bob Robson was manager. Okay. And they were going to pay £500,000. They were going to pay £500,000 for me.
Karaoke.
But what happened was that the Ipswich board would not pay £500,000 for a diabetic. So they pulled out of the deal. When Tottenham came to buy me, it was the end of my contract, and I was at end of season, bargain basement. I went for £105,000. So that was my. And I was earning £18,000. That's not a week, that was a year. And I got a £2,000 signing on fee spread over my 3-year contract.
So
there we go. So that was back in 1982. When I joined, obviously, what happened was...